Here we are. Sådan. What's up, guys? 150 basic Danish phrases. Now, this might look familiar to a lot of you, but I kind of updated here, and I call this the improved 2021 version, right? So, I'm going to give you some basic phrases, and this is very good if you're a beginner or if you just want to brush up on your Danish, if you might have forgotten a thing or two. So, let's begin. Hi, hi, hi. There are many different intonations you can use here. Hi, hello. Hi, hi. God day. God day. God day. Good day, hello. This one is a little more formal, right, as you can see. You don't say it to your friends, that would be weird. But it's okay to say in a more formal context. God day. God day. Yeah. Hello. Hello. Hello, hello. Hi, hello. This is on the phone, like when you pick it up, you're like, hello. Right? You can say it in a nicer way. You can also say it in real life, but then it's more like, you want to draw attention to something like hello, like, so it can sound a little bit rough. Be aware of that. Yeah. Hello. Hello, hello. Ah, yeah, the classic. Velkommen. Velkommen. Welcome. Welcome. Right? Kind of like in English. Velkommen. Yeah. Yeah. Velkommen. All right. Come on. Come on. Good morning. Yeah. Good one. Good morning. Come on. Come on. Come on. Huh. God formiddag. God formiddag. Yeah. So god formiddag. Is like good late morning. That might sound weird to you, but it's kind of like in the hours between maybe 10 and 11:30, something like that, right? Because for is like før, right? So like pre lunch, right? Or midday, because it's between morning and lunch. God formiddag. Yeah. Alright. God eftermiddag. God eftermiddag. Good afternoon. Yeah, pretty straightforward. God eftermiddag. God eftermiddag. God aften. God aften. Good evening. God aften. God aften. God aften. God aften. Godnat. Godnat. God nat. Good night. Godnat. Now, of course, in real life, it's going to have more intonation because, you know, people might be in a certain mood or they have a temperament or there's a vibe. But, yeah, this is how it's pronounced. Godnat. Godnat, godnat, godnat. Beautiful. Moving on. So godt. So God, sleep tight, or literally sleep well. And God is like well. So God. So God. So God. Yeah. Cool. Hi, hi. It's always so funny to say this out of context. Hi, hi. Hi, hi. Bye, bye. Right? This is the most common way to say goodbye to someone, right? Like if you know them, hi, hi. Although some people might just say hi, right? It depends. So, hi, hi, bye, bye. Ses, or vi ses. Vi ses. Vi ses, vi ses, vi ses, right? See you. This vi is, of course, we, like we will see each other again. this S, and that's the ending of this verb. That is not a mistake. That is how we say it. Vi ses. See you. Farvel. Farvel. Goodbye. Farvel. Farvel. And just like in English and many other languages, we don't say this all the time. Because that would be weird, eh? Because it sounds a little bit permanent, eh? A little bit heavy. So, just in some scenarios. Farvel. Farvel, farvel. Whoop-bye. You have this one. Tak. Tak, 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 tak. Tak. Now, you have heard this before. I know you have. Of course you have. Right? So this is, of course, thank you. Tak. Yeah. So short and easy. Mange tak. Tusind tak. Mange tak. Tusind tak. Thanks a lot. Right? So the difference here is that mange tak tends to be a little more formal. Not very. Not like distance or anything, but just, yeah, somewhat more formal. And then tusind tak is, there's more emotion in it. Eh? Like that's what you would say to a friend or someone you know well. Yeah, tusind tak literally means thousand thanks or a thousand thank you. Eh? Yeah. Mange tak. Tusind tak. Nice, nice. Tak for hjælpen. Tak for hjælpen. Thank you for the help. Thank you for the help. Eh? Yeah, that's like a literal translation. Sort of like, thank you for helping me. Tak for hjælpen. Like, the help. Tak for hjælpen. Alright, alright. Selv tak. Selv tak. Selv tak. You're welcome. Alright. So this is like, thank you yourself. Or whatever you want to translate it as. Selv tak. We don't really pronounce the V like selv tak. That's unnatural Danish. Selv tak. We have more ways of saying you're welcome. Here's another one. Det var så lidt. Det var så lidt. You're welcome. It's kind of like, it's nothing. Like it's no big deal. Eh? Det var så lidt. Det var så lidt. It was so little. Yeah, like don't mention it. Det var så lidt. Det var så lidt. Nice. Tak for mad. Tak for mad. Thank you for the food or meal. This is mainly said after a meal. So if someone gives you a banana, you wouldn't say tak for mad. You know, or a snack or a candy, that wouldn't be appropriate or normal. So, after a meal, eh? Like you ate it and someone else cooked. Tak for mad. Tak for mad. Nice. Velbekomme. Velbekomme. And this is like, you're welcome about food. It could also be other situations, but it's especially used about food. Eh? Like you say tak for mad, and then the cook or the chef says velbekomme. Right? Someone might also say this if you're eating and then they walk by and they're like, oh, okay, like enjoy the meal kind of thing. Velbekomme is used like that. Very useful. Nice. Undskyld. Undskyld, undskyld, undskyld. I'm sorry. Right? Undskyld. It's a very good one. Yeah. Undskyld mig. Undskyld mig. Undskyld mig. Excuse me. So it's very similar. You just add the my here. Undskyld mig. Yeah. Cool. Jeg beklager. Det beklager jeg. Jeg beklager. Det beklager jeg. I'm sorry, or my apologies. This one is more formal. This could be in a maybe business context or anything where you want to be a little more detached. Like it's not so personal. I could say this. beklager is sort of like you regret it, right? Beklager. Oh, jeg beklager. You'll see it a lot in formal context. So like, I'm sorry, my apologies, however you want to translate it. Alright, moving on. Det er okay. Det er okay. Det er okay. It's okay. Like that. Yeah. Det er okay. And you probably noticed at first I said it like det er okay. Sort of like this middle word er isn't pronounced. And that is a common thing in Danish, that we can kind of skip some words. And you can do it when you get to a higher level. But just be prepared that the way we speak it fast and the way we speak it slow, well, they're very different. So. Pyt med det. Pyt med det. Pyt med det. Pyt med det is like, it's okay, don't worry about it. Like, don't sweat it. Sort of like, yeah, whatever. Like, pyt med det. Pyt med det. Yeah. Ein. Det går nok. Det går nok. Det går nok. Yeah. Det går nok. It's like, it'll be okay or fine. It'll be alright. Right? Literally, it goes probably, or it'll probably go. And like, it'll be fine, it'll, yeah, not be a problem. And this could be when someone has apologized and you're like, ah, that'll be okay. Or maybe there's a scenario that someone is worried about, maybe they're anxious or nervous. And then you could be like, ah, they go nok, it'll be okay, like, don't worry. Yeah, very useful. They go nok. Yeah. Very basic. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Right. Yeah, this is our keyword here. Yeah, and of course if you say, yeah, yeah, that's kind of like, yeah, 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 yeah. And kind of hear in people's tone what they're trying to say. Nej. Nej, nej. Nej. Nope. That's what it means. Nope. Nej. Kind of like in German. I know you say nein. And we say nej. Yeah. Alright. Måske. 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 Maybe. Right? Literally like may happen. Like måske. It may happen. Sort of like in Spanish puede ser. So that's kind of cool. Måske. Maybe. Selvfølgelig. 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 Of course. Yeah, there's a difference here. I'm sure you noticed, eh? Because like, selvfølgelig, and then selvfølgelig. The slow way, we almost never say that in real life, but I have to tell you as a teacher, right? Just know that there's a difference. In real life, we speak pretty fast. Selvfølgelig. Kind of like that. Alright. Selvfølgelig, selvfølgelig. Det ved jeg ikke. Det ved jeg ikke. Det ved jeg ikke. Det ved jeg ikke. I don't know. Like, that I don't know. I don't know that. Also very useful if you don't know something. Det ved jeg ikke. Awesome. Hvad så? Hvad så? Oh, hvad så? Hvad så? What's up? So what? Then what? Now, I have to explain a little bit here. And so, the way you say it is sort of like the D, the soft D here is usually not pronounced. So I could put an apostrophe, it can literally shup, up here, like hvad så? Hvad så? And it can be a greeting. So you have to kind of read the situation, and like someone walks up, and they're like, hvad så? Like, what's up? But it can also be like, so what? Like, in that case, you're usually going to have an O right here. Og hvad så? And then what? Ik? Or then so what? Yeah. But it could also be then what? And like you're telling a story and then what? Then what happened? Yeah. Og hvad så? Hvad så? So you have to read the situation. But it's very useful. Yeah. Hvad så? Hvad så? Okay, something else that's very basic and it's good to know. Jeg hedder. Jeg hedder. Yeah. My name is, of course. Jeg hedder, jeg hedder, whatever your name is, right? Jeg hedder. Nice. Mit navn er. Mit navn er. Mit navn er. Mit navn er. My name is. This is like the literal one. Mit navn er. Right? My name is. Because the last one was hedder, which is a verb. And sort of like in German, you have that too, like ich heiße or whatever. So this is like my name is in a different way. But most of the time in real life, you're not going to say that. You're just going to like maybe kind of point at yourself or something. You're going to shake someone's hand and then you say your name. Right? So this is just for educational purposes that you're learning these. Hvad hedder du? Or hvad hedder du? Hvad hedder du? What's your name? Right? So this is a question. Hvad hedder du? Hvad hedder du? Hvad hedder du? What's your name? And age, this is just an example. Jeg er 25 år gammel. Jeg er 25 år gammel. 25 years old. Of course, you can just put another number in here. And if you don't know numbers well, then I suggest you check out my video about that. I made it back in February. Like numbers in Danish. It's a very good one if you're basic. Jeg er 25 år gammel. 25 år gammel. Gammel, that means old. Very nice, very nice. Okay. Hvor gammel er du? Hvor gammel er du? Hvor gammel er du? Hvor gammel er du? How old are you? That's a good one. Hvor gammel er du? Hvor kommer du fra? Hvor kommer du fra? Where do you come from? Right? Like that. Hvor kommer du fra? Hvor kommer du fra? Jeg kommer fra. Jeg kommer fra any country. Eh? Jeg kommer fra. It could also be a city or an island or whatever you want to say. Jeg kommer fra. I come from. Alright. Jeg bor i på. Jeg bor i på. I live in or on. Like now, of course, prepositions, that can be a different matter. But jeg bor i, like a country or city. Og på could be like the name of the street or an island, for example. Or if you live on a rooftop, if you're like that. So jeg bor i, jeg bor på. And then just insert the name of the city or the country. All right. Hvor bor du? Og hvor bor du? Hvor bor du? Hvor bor du? Where do you live? Hvor bor du? Yeah. Cool. Hvordan går det? Hvordan går det? How you doing? Or how's it going? Right? Very, very useful. Hvordan går det? Yeah, yeah. Hvordan går det? Det går godt. Det går godt. It's going well or I'm doing well. Det går godt. Det går godt. Det går godt. Det går ikke så godt. Det går ikke så godt. Det går ikke så godt. It's not going that well. It's going kind of bad, actually. Det går ikke så godt. Går ikke så godt. Jeg er glad. Jeg er glad. Jeg er glad. Jeg er glad. I'm happy. Jeg er glad. And this is a feeling, so you can just say jeg er, and then any kind of feeling here. If you're sad or tired or upset or whatever. And we'll actually get to that in a second. Now you have this one right here. Jeg ked af det. Jeg ked af det. I'm sad or upset. Jeg ked af det. Okay. Ked af det. It's kind of long. I know. Jeg keder mig. Jeg keder mig. I'm bored. Jeg keder mig. I keder mig. Jeg er sulten. Jeg er sulten. I'm hungry. Jeg er sulten. Jeg er sulten. A lot of repetition here. Pay attention and repeat if you can. Jeg er tørstig. Jeg er tørstig. I'm thirsty. Åh, jeg er tørstig. Jeg skal have noget vand. I got to get some water. Jeg er tørstig. Like that. Hvad med dig? Og hvad med dig? If we speak very fast, then this dig becomes like da, and could sound like that. Hey, hvad med dig? Don't experiment with that yet. That's more if you are at the higher level. Hvad med dig? How about you? And like, are you also thirsty or whatever? Like, you just said something about yourself and then you want to check on the other person. Hvad med dig? Okay. Jeg fryser. Jeg fryser. Jeg fryser. I'm freezing or I'm cold. Right? Now this doesn't have to mean that you're really freezing, like it's really cold. But just that you're kind of cold and it's uncomfortable. Right? Jeg fryser. Like that. Jeg sveder. Jeg sveder. I'm sweating. Jeg sveder. It's a good practice here, right? The soft D. Sveder. Sveder. Okay. Jeg klar. Jeg klar. Jeg klar. I'm ready. Ready for what? I don't know. Can be any situation. Jeg klar. Klar, klar, klar. Alright. Jeg spændt. Jeg spændt. I'm excited or psyched, like about something. You go, oh yeah, kind of like that. Jeg spændt. Jeg spændt. Okay. Jeg glæder mig. Jeg glæder mig. Oh, jeg glæder mig. Jeg glæder mig. Kind of like that. We say it fast. I'm excited or looking forward to it. Now, this is a little bit different. I mean, it kind of overlaps with jeg spent. Jeg spent is like you're more psyched and pumped up. Where jeg glæder mig has emphasis on the thing that's coming and that future thing you're looking forward to. So, they're a little bit different. Jeg glæder mig. Yeah. Nice. Very nice. Jeg lidt nervøs. Jeg lidt nervøs. I'm a little nervous. Jeg lidt nervøs. You see how it's similar to English, like nervøs. You'll see this a lot. There's a lot of words that are similar to English, but still different. Like, that's the key. Gotta remember that. Held og lykke. Held og lykke. Held og lykke. Good luck. Now, the translation here can be a little bit funny because hell means luck and lykke means happiness. So it's like luck and happiness. Well, anyway, this is what we say. And this is how we wish someone good luck. Held og lykke. Yeah. Held og lykke. And then we're getting poi poi. Poi poi. Now, I don't say this so much myself, but there are some people who do say it. Poi poi is like good luck or all the best, and like to a specific situation, maybe something that's challenging like that, some people will say it. Poi poi. Mm-hmm. Knækkerbræk. Knækkerbræk. Knæk og bræk. So this is like good luck, like break a leg. Like maybe something that seems kind of risky or dangerous or, yeah, it's sort of uncertain. You could say that, knækkerbræk. It doesn't mean break a leg, but it does mean sort of like break and break. We have many different words for breaking in Danish, and these are just two of them. Knæk og bræk. Funny. Prosit. Prosit. Prosit, prosit. So this is like bless you or God bless you after someone sneezed. That's what we say. Prosit. Yeah. Alright, sounds kind of Russian or something, but this is what we say. Tillykke. 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 Congratulations, congrats, grats, whatever. Tillykke. Tillykke, tillykke. It's a good one to know. It'll make you popular. Tillykke med fødselsdagen. Tillykke med fødselsdagen. Tillykke med fødselsdagen. Happy birthday. That's a long one. Fødselsdagen. But that is birthday. The birthday. Yeah. Tillykke med din fødselsdag. Oh, even better. God jul. God jul. God jul. Merry Christmas. Yeah. God jul. That's right. Yeah, just like good Christmas, eh? God jul. You always say glædelig jul, actually. I could include that too. God jul, glædelig jul. Godt nytår. Godt nytår. Happy New Year. Eh? Godt nytår. Very nice. God weekend. God weekend. Yeah. You could also say, hey, en god weekend. But most of the time, you're not going to hear that, hey. That's kind of rare. Most of the time, we're just going to say, god weekend, god weekend. Good weekend. Ha' en god dag. Have en god dag. Have a good day or a nice day. Ha' en god dag. Could be different context here. Exactly. Fortsæt god dag. Fortsæt god dag. Fortsæt god dag. Have a continued good day. That looks weird. I know the translation is like, huh, continued? But that's because it's fortsæt is something that has continued or is continuing. Eh? Like your day is already good. And then the person hopes that it'll still be good. Continues to be good. This is usually what you hear in shops. Like if you're in a supermarket, they'll say this. Or they'll say god dag. It depends. I lige måde. I lige måde. You too. Or like right back at ya. Right? This is nice. You can also say tak I lige måde. You don't have to, but it's common. Right? Tak og I lige måde. Tak I lige måde. Or just I lige måde. You too. Yeah. Alright. Fit. Fit. Great, awesome. How you want to translate it? Super duper. Fit. Fit. It literally means fat, like grease. But this is how we say it. Fit. Okay? Sådan. 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 So many different intonations you can use here. Sådan. Like, there you go. That's it. And like, that's what I'm talking about. That's the right way. Sådan. Sådan. Er det rigtigt? Er det rigtigt? Er det rigtigt? Is it true? Really? This is a very common one we say when we are sort of not believing something. Like, huh? Really? Er det rigtigt? Virkelig. Virkelig. virkelig, virkelig, really? We use this one too, but we use the previous one more, definitely. Virkelig. Mener du det? Mener du det? Do you mean that? Mener du det? Gør jeg. Hvad mener du? Hvad mener du? What do you mean? Hvad betyder det? Hvad betyder det? Ja, og hvad betyder det? You can play around with the stress. What does that mean? Hvad betyder det? In Danish, we have two words for mean. One is mener, and another one is betyder. And I'm not gonna cover that right now, but I'm just telling you, we have two words, so don't be surprised. Hvad siger du? Siger du? Hvad siger du? What are you saying? And, oh, what do you say? Could actually be both situations. Hvad siger du? Hvad siger du? Very useful. Hvad er det? Hvad er det? What's that? And, like you point at something, you're like, nej, nej, så det. Right? You don't get what it is. Hvad er det? What's that? Hvem er han? Hun. Hvem er han? Hun. Who is he or who is she? Right? Hvem er han? Hvem er hun? Right? Og hvem er du? You can put any personal pronoun. Hvem er de? Hvem er vi? Who are we? La la la. Mm? Very useful. Hvem er? Who is or who are? Hvorfor? Hvorfor? Why? Hvorfor? Hvorfor? Hvorfor, hvorfor, hvorfor? Mm. Hvordan? 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 How? Like in what way? Hvordan? Hvornår? Hvornår? When? Hvornår? Hvornår? Ooh, a little too fast there. Hvad laver du? Hvad laver du? Hvad laver du? Hvad laver du? What do you do or what are you doing? See, this one can be used in different kind of context. It could be like, hey, what are you doing right now? What are you up to? But it could also be, what do you do in life? And like, do you study? Do you work? Are you collecting bird bones? And whatever. Så, hvad laver du? Yeah. It's a very useful one. Very good to know. And that was the last one for today, guys. So, I hope you learned something. Well, I know you did. And you're going to learn a lot more if you're taking notes. Taking notes is just super useful. I want to say a big thanks to all the members of this channel. Your support means a lot. And it's so great to see that a lot of you are joining in and enabling me to make better videos. And also, I'm so happy that you decided to be serious about this, to really take your learning seriously, because it really is something. So you can also become a monthly member, a paying member of the channel, by checking one of the links in the description. However, if you don't want to pay every month, and if you want to own the videos for life, then what you can do is check the other link and go to the website, the Danish Mastery website. And there you'll get lifetime access to all the videos. So far, that's 360, actually a little bit more. And, you know, every time I make a new video, it goes up there. So it's like ever growing. It's just keeps growing and growing. You also get some bonuses. You get an ebook here with some Danish phrases. You get some PDFs with exercises. You get a couple of podcast episodes, some slides, you know, like slides from this video, for example. You can print out or whatever you want. And then you get access to a Danish WhatsApp group where you can ask me to add you, and then I'll answer any questions that you have about the Danish language. So that's kind of cool. It's a lot of things. It's many videos, but it's not just videos. All right. Yeah. I think that's pretty much it. Like I said, thank you so much for watching. This was part one. I'm gonna do part two later, another day, and I'm also very excited about that. With that being said, thank you very much, and I'll see you soon.